Today's topic is skills videos. What is a skills video? Why do you need one? And how can you put one together? And I think that this is an especially important topic right now because, you know, seasons, events, even the events that are happening are not happening in quite the same capacity that they normally do. You know, summertime, we've usually all got all sorts of events and opportunities to make highlight films. And highlight films are great. You know, I will say that right off the bat. A skills video should not replace your highlight video if you have the opportunity to make a highlight video. But for folks who don't have a lot of live footage, or even folks that do, but maybe it's a little bit older and you just want something to show coaches, a skills video is an excellent option for that. So that's what we are talking about today. As always, if you have any questions along the way, feel free to pop them into the chat. I am more than happy to address those as I go through my topic, if it's relevant to the topic. If it's just a totally different recruiting question, I'm also happy to get to those as well. I will probably get to those at the end because now we are starting to kind of repurpose some of these videos and edit them together into smaller pieces. And so going off on a tangent in the middle of my chat makes the editing portion a little bit more difficult, but feel free to pop any question you have about recruiting or CaptainU into the chat. If you are watching it on the replay, or if you would prefer just to have a separate conversation, you can always reach me directly at Eric, E-R-I-C, at CaptainU.com. So with that, let's dive into today's topic, and that is skills videos. And the structure that I'm going to use today as we talk about skills videos is first we're going to talk about what even is a skills video. Because I think some folks aren't quite familiar. We're then going to talk about why. Why are skills videos important? Why? What's great about them, especially right now? And then we're going to talk about how to put one together. So if you are curious about skills videos, today's discussion is for you. And so first and foremost, what is a skills video? Basically, a skills video is a non-live video demonstrating key athletic skills for recruiting purposes. And by non-live, I mean, it's not from a competition. You know, if you are a soccer player, then hey, it's not from a game. This is maybe you running some drills or practicing or scrimmaging. Or you can do sport important workouts as well. That's another great thing for a skills video. Basically, it's a highlight video that shows coaches who you are and why they should be interested, and gives coaches the opportunity to see you as an athlete that do not come from a live situation. So there's some very distinct advantages to putting together a skills video, or some good reasons to put together a skills video. But at the end of the day, that's what it is. It can be very close to a normal highlight video. If you are an athlete who, what makes you great as an athlete is your ability to read your opponents, your ability to adjust and have an high IQ for the sport. Great, you can use kind of scrimmage style footage to still get that across, even if you're not able to get actual live video. But it's a whole spectrum, all the way from basically scrimmages down to individual workouts. You know, doing drills, you know, things like footwork drills or your jumping skills, things like that, to specific workouts. You know, I know for my rowers and things like that, there are specific workouts that coaches like to see. So basically, it's any video that acts as a highlight video, but is not from a live situation. And so the why would we want a non-live video? Well, there's a couple really good reasons. And I think it's important, first off, to again touch on why do we create videos for coaches? Why is video important to recruiting? And, you know, hey, 20 years ago, or I mean, shoot, even longer, if you wanted to get recruited, you play well, coaches watch you play, and, you know, most often it's maybe the schools in your area, they give you an offer, great. We're done. You know, hey, it was a simpler time. It didn't take as much work as an athlete, But you didn't really have that many options in terms of what schools are accessible to you, unless you were just one of the top nationally ranked athletes or something like that. And, you know, hey, recruiting is great now, because as an athlete, maybe here in Colorado, you have access to coaches all over the country, on the West Coast, on the East Coast, the South, all the way up North. You know, really, athletes today have access to coaches anywhere. But it's not always easy for those coaches to get their eyes on you. And obviously, coaches don't want to recruit you on just a good message or just some stats. They need to see the context. They need to see the performance. And so video is just so important to that. And what's nice about creating a skills video is it is a controlled situation. You know, if you go and film a live event, you don't know how your teammates are going to perform. You don't know how the other team is going to perform. You know, in general, in live situations, it's much better to have a really difficult game or event than somebody that you're just clobbering and running over. And so even if you're having the best game on the planet, the other team, you know, might not be kind of up to snuff. And so your video kind of suffers as a result of that. And so that's why creating live video, well, probably in most cases, is the best thing that coaches like to see. You know, it can take months to put together a great highlight video. And in many cases, we want to be having conversations with coaches as soon as possible. As we've discussed in the past, you don't get recruited in a single message. You don't get recruited in a single interaction. It happens as you build rapport with coaches over time. And so having a skills video that you can share with coaches while you're putting together your other video is an excellent thing to do. And it's great because it's a controlled situation. If you are trying to do a drill that you want to show coach, you know, if you said, hey, I have perfect form, maybe you're a golfer, and you say, my form is excellent. And I really, you know, all of my clubs perform exactly as they should in every situation because my form is excellent. Well, if you are putting together a skills video, you can do it over and over again until you perfectly hit exactly how you want to. I was recently interviewing a national champion college coach, and we were talking about skills videos and why they were so important. A national champion cheer coach. And we were discussing skills videos, and that kind of gave me the idea to do today's chat. And he said, you know, I never understand, you know, their program publishes, like, these are the specific tumbling skills that you need to hit in order to earn a spot on our team. And he's like, people will send me in video of themselves practicing and they're not hitting it perfectly. And it's like, why did you even do that? You know, spend another half an hour on it, get it just right. Well, in some cases, we all know it can take more than another half an hour if you're practicing something. But spend a little more time on it, get it perfect, and then send it over. You have complete control of the situation. You have all the time in the world. And so make sure that you are, you know, whatever you're trying to demonstrate to a coach, that you hit it just right. Another kind of advantage of the control you have in a skills video is you can design the video around the skills that you want coaches to know about you. Let's go again back to the soccer example. And for those of you watching, feel free to pop your sport and your grad you're in so that I can give examples relevant to you if you'd like. But let's go back to the soccer example. You know, maybe I say, when I'm thinking about who I am as a recruit and I want to show coaches what about me they should be interested in, maybe I say I've got excellent ball control. I can place the ball exactly where I want. I can do, you know, all sorts of footwork and get out of tricky situations. Well, great. Design your skills video to show just that. You know, think of the footwork drills that have gotten you the skills that you have, and show those to coaches. And you can really say, maybe there's two or three key bullet point level skills that you exactly want to show coaches. You could film five games, and if there's not the right situation in the game, maybe you don't have the footage that you want. But if you are designing a skills video, you can say, these are the drills that have gotten my footwork to the place where I'm super proud of it. I'm going to show those exact drills. You know, you can kind of show maybe a couple different situations, and you can really design the video to show coaches exactly what you want. You have control over the situation. So that's the first key advantage, and definitely a big advantage. A second advantage, and I would say this is probably even more important, is that it's just easier. There are lower barriers to entry when it comes, thank you, Heidi, 2021 basketball. There are lower barriers to entry when it comes to putting together a skills video. First of all, lower technical barriers to entry. You know, you don't need to have a professional camera with a high pod that gets a whole view of the field, which, you know, I've said time and time again that you can make a fine highlight video with just cell phone footage, but it does take some more effort. You know, maybe you have to have a parent or somebody on the sideline. You can do a skills video by yourself, and you don't need anything fancy. If you have access to a cell phone or a camcorder or a tablet with a camera, set it up on the sideline or whatever, and do your drills. You can do it by yourself or with one or two other people. You don't need any fancy equipment. You don't need any fancy editing. You just want to show coaches what you got. And it's just easier to put together a skills video. It takes less coordination and less effort. And especially important right now during the times of COVID-19 that unfortunately we're all dealing with in sports and I suppose in the rest of our life. But there's just less opportunity for live footage. There's less tournaments happening. There's seasons are getting canceled or postponed, or and in some situations when you are allowed to play, you're not allowed to have the people on the sidelines. And so getting your camera in there is a little more difficult. And so it's just, there's less opportunity for footage. And there is nothing that says you can't pop into your backyard or into the park down the street or to, maybe your school that has a practice field that's open or something like that. You can find the space to make a skills video. And, even beyond that, it's showing coaches that you're getting creative to continue to hone your skills, to continue to show them why they should be interested in you. It's just all the things that you want to be showing to coaches about yourself that are difficult in a time like this, you can get across with a skills video. And so I think this is something every athlete should be working on. It's gonna get you practicing. It's gonna get you improving. It's creating content that you can share with coaches. It's showing coaches that you're still invested in this and you're still trying to get recruited. And so it's just, there are so many great reasons to put together a skills video. Okay, so we talked about the what is a skills video? We talked about the why. And so now I just wanna talk straightforward about the how of putting together a skills video. And where you wanna start is in planning. Just like when we talked about building the profile or putting together a proper highlight video or sending a message, it needs to start with the plan. Ask yourself, what do I want coaches to know about me? What are the key 2, 3, maybe 4 bullet point level things that you want coaches to know? A skills video, just like a highlight video, just like your message, doesn't need to get everything across all at once about you, period. I hear a lot of discussion on like, well, I want to show coaches my strengths and my weaknesses. It's important to know your strengths and weaknesses, but today, coaches' attention spans are shorter. Your videos need to be shorter. They need to be high impact. And showing a bunch of weaknesses in a 3-minute video, I don't think is the best way to get recruited in 2020. I think certainly maybe that could be up for some discussion. But in my opinion, you want to be showing the absolute most important things about you and really nothing else. This needs to be high impact. So plan first, think first. What are those 2, 3, 4 skills I want to demonstrate? And how can I get those across? Are there drills or workouts or things that I can do? Do I need to have other people? Does it need to be kind of a scrimmage situation or can it just be individual? Think first. Don't just take your camera out and go, all right, now I'm going to figure out what I'm going to do. Get a piece and a pen and write down some bullet points and come up with what you want to do. It's going to be much easier for you to film. It's going to be much easier for you to edit, however rudimentary that editing may be. And it's just going to be easier for you. And one really important thing that you can do during the planning phase is ask coaches what they like to see. What a great opportunity to check in with a coach, to say, hey coach, I'm planning on putting together a skills video this weekend. I really would like to know, what types of key skills or drills would you like to see from an athlete who's putting together a skills video? It's, again, showing this coach like, wow, this athlete is really motivated. They're very much interested in me. They want to customize their video to me and my program. It's getting across so much to that coach before you even have put the video together. So ask the coaches what they like to see. Think about what you want to show them and come up with a plan first. That is going to make all the subsequent steps easier and more effective for you. Second is figure out your equipment that you're going to need. First and foremost, and most obviously, you're going to need some sort of camera. Most cell phones are more than good enough. I know that my cell phone right now has a way better video capability than the camcorder that I used to make my highlight video back in 2006 when I was a senior going through recruiting. If you've got access to a cell phone or a tablet or a camera, that's going to be good enough for you. You're probably going to need some sort of way to set the camera up. I know right now I am using a pile of a few knickknacks on my desk to hold up my web camera. And so you don't need a fancy tripod or anything like that. And if you have a friend or a family member who can help you out and just come film for you, that's great too. But you're going to need some way to set your camera up, of course. And whatever equipment you might need for the drills that you want to do. Maybe you need some cones that you're going to do some footwork or some dribbling drills, or you're going to need access to a cord or something like that. You know, obviously, think about that. That's kind of part of the planning phase. Next thing, the next thing in my note was the venue. You know, hey, we talked about that. In some cases, you can maybe do it in your backyard or in a park down the street or at your school, practice fields, you know, figure out a place to do it. And I recommend, you know, go out early in the morning or kind of when it's starting to get cool. I know out here in Denver, it's like 100 degrees right now. But also in many cases, if you have to go to like a public park or something like that to film your skills video, there's probably going to be less people out, which is certainly nice for a video. Hey, if you're just doing it in your backyard, you can probably do whenever you want. But I do think it's worth putting a little bit of thought into where am I going to go film this video? And how can I have a little more control over the situation if it is a public place? Less chance to encounter other people. If it's like Denver right now, maybe it'll be less hot. So yeah, go early in the morning or go later in the afternoon, kind of plan that out. And then, of course you just go out and film yourself, get your key skills. And like I mentioned with the cheer coach that I had interviewed a few weeks ago, make sure you do everything until you get it just right. The last thing you want to do is just run through everything once and get back home and plug in your camera or start looking at your videos and it's just sloppy and you feel like you have to go do it again. Do it until you hit it right. If you have the opportunity, you can kind of watch yourself on the sideline and see how it looks. Though I recommend not doing that too often. You don't want to do that after every drill, after everything you do, because then it's going to take you all day. And frankly, you're not going to be in the zone as much as an athlete if you keep going back and looking at your phone and getting distracted by your notifications. So don't spend too much time going back and forth and watching, but get out there, film your drills, hit everything well. Do it over and over again until you're doing it just right. And then, it's time to edit. Your editing does not need to be fancy. I say this time and time again. You don't need ESPN style editing. You don't need music in the background. That was a huge mistake I made in recruiting, as I spent 3 months editing my video because I wanted it to look amazing and the music to go with it. And now that I go back and watch my video, the music is like really aggressive screaming music that no coach is ever going to want to listen to. They probably watched it on mute. And I think that's the running joke with coaches, is they watch your videos on mute. They don't care about the editing. So don't waste too much effort on that. But I do think it's important to make it look good if you can. Cut out the pieces that are sloppy. stack it so that it's really high impact, maybe put it in sections, put a little title about what it is that you're doing and what you're demonstrating. You know, try and make it look good if you can. And this is where I'm excited to announce that CaptainU now has video editing available for any athlete. You don't just need to be a Gold or a Platinum subscriber. I'm going to go ahead and post the link into the chat. Shop.CaptainU.com. We do have just a la carte video editing options available now. This is something that folks have been asking for a while, and we just didn't have a great way to do it. And so only our Gold and Platinum subscribers had access to that video editing in the past. But if you, you know, don't want to sign up for a Gold plan or a Platinum plan, but you still want a video, you now have access to that editing. So that is something that we can help you out with, whether it's a live highlight video or a skills video. But this is also something that you can do yourself. You do not have to buy an editing package from CaptainU in order to make a skills video. You know, feel free to just pop one together. You know, I know that my computer comes with just a super basic video editing software. I think YouTube even has some editing tools. You upload your video and chop it up on there. You know, there are so many ways that you can pull this together that you can learn quickly and easily. And if you have trouble with that, you know, feel free to shoot me a note at eric@captainu.com, E-R-I-C. I'll be more than happy to kind of help you out with that. And also, if you have questions about the CaptainU video editing options, feel free to shoot me a note as well. That is something that you know, we're really excited to have available for folks. People have been asking for it, so we've got that. So edit your video. Put it together. Get it to try and, I would say, like 3 to 4 minutes max. It's okay to be as low as like a minute and 30 in some cases, I would say. But I probably want to be closer to like 3 minutes is probably about ideal. That's just a personal preference. I find, you know, you want to have enough there to really show coaches what you got, but not such a long video that they zone out or start skipping around. So the last step is to distribute it. You know, hey, you got your video together, now what? And there's a few key things you want to do. First and foremost, throw it in your CaptainU profile. Copy the link if it's on YouTube or Huddle or Crossover. If you get it through CaptainU, we're going to add it to YouTube for you. So copy the link, paste it into the video section of your profile. Your profile point score is going to show up. It's going to show up in the feed of coaches who are following you. It's always good to have people just coming across your stuff. And so make sure to add it to your profile. Excuse me. And then the last thing, and the most important, is get out there and send messages to coaches. Show them your video. What an excellent opportunity to send a message. Hey, coach, I just put together this skills video. I'd love it if you could check it out. And I'd love to set up a time to go over it and see if you have any feedback for me. And hey, if you were listening to what I said and following all the steps, and you had asked coaches what they like to see in a skills video before you asked them, what an excellent opportunity to follow up. You know, hey coach, thanks so much for the tips on putting together a skills video. This weekend I went out and got my skills video done. I just threw together a quick edit. Here's the video. I'd love it if you could give me some feedback. It's an excellent opportunity to show the coach that you're the type of athlete who follows up, who listens to what they say, all the things that you again want to get across with the coaches at the schools that you're interested in. So make sure that you are sending it out. I think sometimes I work with athletes who are very excited to get their video done. They post it to their profile and then they sit back and wait for coaches and they watch the how many views am I getting, and they just sit there waiting. Get out there and send it to coaches. That's something that we have extensively spoken about in previous live sessions. I'm sure that we will have a whole nother messaging session again, just because it's that important. But distribution of your video is key. You know, you got to execute on the full thing. So just kind of in summary, you know, come up with a plan, get your equipment together, figure out where you're going to do it, go out and film, throw together a quick edit, and then distribute your video. And you know, hey, this is all stuff that you can do right now by yourself, regardless of whether your season or your big event or whatever is happening. You know, this is something that you have control over, that you can do, that coaches like to see, that's important to recruiting. So if you are interested in making a skills video, if you want feedback, if you have questions, feel free to reach out to me at eric@captainu.com. That's just about all the time I've got for today, but I hope that was helpful. I appreciate those of you who joined today as always. And if you have ideas for topics you'd like me to cover in subsequent live sessions, feel free to pop it into the chat. I always go back and check and like to see what ideas y'all come up with. And in fact, a lot of these, this is my 15th session. I think 4 or 5 have come from great ideas that were in the comments. If this was helpful to you, I would appreciate if you were helpful to me. Share this with your teammates, with your league, with your friends, anybody who you think would find this useful. Go ahead and share it with them. If you have questions or any questions about recruiting or CaptainU, you can always reach me at eric@captainu.com. I'm happy to answer questions via email or schedule a call. So thank you so much for joining, and we will catch you next week.